my turn to take care.
Ah, Herr Morgan.
Oh, tell me, is your people Jacobites or English lovers, Arthur?
My people were peasants. We had no time for politics.
My dad would say that no politics was politics.
That old...
There ain't no judgment here. Most folks hate the Negroes, they hate the Redskins, the Jews, even us Irish. You ain't so free of politics.
I hate everyone just the same.
Well, in that case, you're gonna want what I just found for us.
What's that?
I was riding around a couple of days back. I come across this old cabin. A couple of fuckers lazing about outside all liquored up. I didn't think nothing of it. But then I come across this hunter down by the river. And he tells me they're a stick-up crew. Says they hit a train a couple of days back near Emerald Ranch. Nice fella he was. Shared a bottle we did. Then I robbed the bastard blind.
You believed him?
No reason not to. If he's right, it'll be a big haul for us. I saw three of them, maybe more, but I reckon you and me, we could take them real easy.
All right. What the hell? Let's go check it out.
Them sons of bitches think they're mean. They're about to get a lesson in mean.
You just keep your cool, you hear me? You all right, girl?
Right, follow me. Whoa!
How far is this place?
It's a bit of a ride. Not too bad. Back up north a stretch. Not far from the state line.
All right.
Hard left coming up.
Going to be off the road up ahead. Up here, Morgan. Let's leave the horses here and go to rest on foot. Don't want them to hear us coming.
Here, I'll deal with them. Let's make sure we keep one of them alive to tell us where they stashed the money.
Hope you know what you're doing.
Look, there's one of them outside. This is good.
It is?
Leave it to me. I'll do the talking. You hang back. There.
Oh. Now I'm gonna give you about 5 seconds to get the hell off my property, boy.
Look, don't want no trouble. Just thought you might like to know we passed a big posse of lawmen headed this way. About a dozen of them coming up east.
What? Where?
Right here. Heads up, Arthur. Here come the rest of them.
Watch it. They're coming out.
Put your hands up. Nice and easy. You saw what we did to your pals here.
Okay, okay, I give up. Don't shoot. I ain't armed.
Tell us where you stash your money and we'll let you live.
Well, all right, take it easy. Behind the wall in the bedrooms, if you stick your hand between the gap.
All right, you go grab the money. I'll keep an eye on Sunshine here. You know what? Just get the hell out of here and don't look back. Here we are. We got some good stuff.
Why don't you see what else you can find, Sean?
Told you we'd take him, no problem, didn't I?
You did good. Let's see what the pay is first.
Dug this up all by myself. A proper lead.
All right.
You heard him, right? He said the stash was behind a loose board in the bedroom. You find anything yet? Don't want to overstay our welcome, do we? Hey, it's over there.
Hey. This is more like it. Good work.
Hey, what about my car? I found a place, didn't I?
All right, here. share. Supplies don't appear by magic, you know.
All right, don't need to lecture again. I'll see you back at camp.
Never know what folks got stashed. There's gotta be other places out there like this.
Okay, my girl. Yeah.
Oh, this is a pretty pickle.
What the devil are you looking at?
I'm sorry?
No, I'm sorry. I'm ruined. Ruined!
How so?
It's a disaster. Who wants to see a woman wrangle wild animals who doesn't have any bloody wild animals? Come to America, they said. Come to the land of opportunity, they said. Sod you, Daddy, I said. I'm going to America to make it on the stage. I didn't want to be in the army. Ooh. Now look at me. The old git will have a field day.
I didn't really understand any of that.
I had an act. The bravest woman in the world. The animal wrangler. Watch her tame wild beasts.
And you were the woman?
Of course I was the bloody woman. Look at me. It's the stage. Grease paint. Tears. No one wants to see a man wrangling wild animals. And no one wants to see a woman wrangling nothing. Can I borrow your gun? I want to shoot myself. You see, I'm buggered.
Why?
My animals. They escaped. And now I'm buggered.
What escaped?
A priceless Ranjaniki tiger from the slopes of the Hindu Heights. A fantastic, elusive zebra from the plains of Ongo Bongo by the shores of the Limpopo. And a magnificent lion from the grasslands of Tanganyika.
Yeah, I see your problem. They're pretty hard to come by around here.
Listen, friend. Help a fellow out, would you? I'm beyond desperate. If you see any of them, will you bring them back here?
If I see a tiger or a lion or a zebra just roaming around.
Exactly. Well, I believe the zebra's up near Lonnet Sod. Distinctive creature that he is. I'll make it worth your while.
All right. Madam.
It's bloody Margaret, not madam. Margaret. Mistress of fucking danger.
Easy now. Yep. Yeah. Easy, easy. There we go. Easy, whoa. Whoa there. Yeah. Faster. Whoa, back. Look here. What they done to you? Whoa there, easy. Whoa, whoa, easy. Easy, it's okay. Easy. You're okay. Whoa now, easy. Whoa. You'll be all right. Let's go. Your stripes better not rub off on my pants. Ah!
found him! Our zebra!
Well, you can call him that. Although he's as much a zebra as you are a lady animal wrangler.
Oh, dear. You're missing the point, aren't you? It's an illusion. A trick of the eye to bamboozle the senses. Confound comprehension.
Hoodwink your audience?
Hoodwink? Our audiences? Dear boy, don't be so dreadfully literal. No one will pay for the truth. They only pay for deception. The allure of the stage. Dreams and reality. What is the greater conjuring trick? Lassoing some poor beast on the plains of mumbo-jumbo land and shipping it here so it can dance the polka? Or turning there, in the glare of those arc lamps, something mundane into something extraordinary. It's the difference between prose and poetry. It's alchemy. We're selling dreams, dear boy.
Well, as long as you don't pay me with tickets to your show.
Yes. Well, it's not everyone's cup of tea.
And speaking of my payment...
Of course. I shall make it worth your while. But, first, we shall need the whole menagerie back before we can think about that. My assistant's gone for the tiger.
Tiger?
Yes. And taken our remaining lion in case it could lend a paw. They're down there on Caligar Way. Please, I hate to ask...
All right, I'll see what I can do. Easy there. Hey, mister.
Oh.
Miss.
Howdy, mister.
Did you lose a tiger?
Yeah, you found one?
Nah, I found your caravan down the way. Margaret said that you might need a hand.
Oh, you weren't wrong. That tiger's missing. I sent our best lion out to find him, and... now he's missing, too. It is a right old predicament.
You're lying from Timbuktu, weren't you?
Oh, from Valentine, I think. He might be more of a kind of dog than a lion, but in a certain light, a feller could never tell.
Of course. Which way'd he go?
Into them shrubs over there.
Okay.
Why don't you hop up on the wagon and I'll see if I can find his track.
Okay. That first set of shrubs, that's where I lost sight of him.
I got it. Got the trail. These are paw prints.
Let me bring the wagon along.
You paint this dog? There's some pigment here. Looks like blood to me. Shit. What's this? Oh, darn. I found your dog. Dog, ex-lion.
Hey, boy! Oh, where's the rest of them?
I think a cougar took them.
Oh, that'd be Stripey. And I always thought they got along.
Your tiger is a wild cat?
Uh-huh.
What else? You still need it back?
Oh, yes, sir. She's our star attraction.
Well, let's hope it wants the other half of its dinner.
The other half? Really?
I'm gonna put them in your wagon. You find somewhere to hide.
Oh. Well, behind that log, then.
Okay. Grubs up. Stay down. She won't be too far away.
I went out to find a tiger.
Cougar? Yeah. Me?
And I end up losing a lion.
Yeah, dog.
Ain't having any luck.
Well, if that's what you're dealing with, you didn't have any luck to begin with. Cougars and dogs.
Hey, it ain't what you got in this life. It's what you make of it.
Well, that's very wise of you. Especially when you're lacking zebras and tigers. Hey. Keep your head down. It's coming.
Look, I really don't think she'll eat the dog. Like I said, friends.
Shut it.
Oh, I guess she's real hungry.
She's feral. I'm locking her in. Let's go.
We got her! Okay. Drive, will you? And I'll keep an eye on her.
Sure thing. Idiot.
Let's get her back to Mr. Margaret. She's still eating. I would have thought, since they was close and all.
Well, wild creatures turn on each other. Seeming friendly one minute, dinner the next. This comes easy. I mean, I should know. I've run with a few of them myself.
Is that right?
No, not really. Hey, I realize I ain't properly introduced myself.
Sally Nash.
Arthur Morgan.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Tell me, Miss Nash, how you end up in this racket?
I guess it's always been my inclination, you know? Wild beasts and the like. I met Mr. Margaret. We got to talking, and you can probably tell, in this field, he's the ace of spades.
He's a card, all right.
It's my modest hope, one day, to be the world's second bravest woman animal wrangler.
I'd say you got that sewn up and then some.
You think? I hope so. Top five, at least. Depends on how many more fellers throw their hat in the ring.
Maybe one of these days, the best female for the job will actually be a female.
Oh, I don't know if that'll ever happen. We lost the main road around here when the dust was up. Be careful, or you might get wrecked too.
Okay. You know the only thing to do in a dust storm is wait it out?
Mr. Margaret's a lot of things, but best female navigator ain't one of them.
I imagine you're right about that.
We was tearing around here, looking for any kind of landmark, when over we go. Whole caravan toppled. Found each other and some shelter, but when the wind died down, the animals was gone.
And now they're back. Some of them, at least.
Thanks to you.
Aw, you would have managed it yourself. I just helped you along.
If you ever want to get in the sideshow business, I'm sure there'd be a place for a fellow like you.
I'll leave the professional theatrics to better women than me.
There it is, the caravan.
Couldn't miss him if you wanted to.
Mr. Margaret!
Aha! I see you found each other.
Sure did, Mr. Margaret.
Jolly good, jolly good.
You know, tarring and feathering a donkey is one thing.
I beg your pardon? It's grease paint. Makeup.
But playing dolls dressed up with a wild animal, you're gonna want to be a lot more careful.
Strappy ate King, Mr. Margaret. I saw her do it.
I always thought they got along.
Oh, she liked him just fine. She licked her chops and asked for seconds. Hey, speaking of which, you got any more word on that runaway lion, or are you gonna pay me for these misfits?
Look, I'm well aware that we're not Royal Command performance material. Daddy, you were right, goddamn you! But a cow barn in Rhodes is hardly Drury Bloody Lane.
You got any word on the lion?
Yes, yes, I've got word on the lion. Shit is the word. Someone saw him near Emerald Ranch. As you know, we're lately very short on lions. So, I'd be very grateful. All kinds of grateful.
There's only one kind of grateful I care about.
So long, mister.
Be a dear and fix me a gin.
Okay, there. Yeah. Move! Easy now. Yep. Go, go. Easy.
Holy time! We caught a terror in here!
Boy! I should go and get my repeater.
What's the ruckus, boys?
Get back! We got a cursed creature in here!
Oh, yeah?
It's as big as a mule and as mean as a hellcat!
It looked like a lion to me.
That's a dog in there.
Dog?
Now, you'll excuse me. Step aside.
What?
I said step aside.
Yeah, boy.
Didn't look like no dog.
Come here, boy.
Let's go.
Look what you've done! Look what you've done!
Son of a bitch. I'll take care of this.
He shot the thing! Is he dead? I pray that thing's a goner! Whoever owned that beast got some
answers. Hey, move!
I've never seen one of those before, and I hope I don't again.
All right.
Let's go, girl.
Dear God!
Wow. Fine horse there.
What
oh, whoa.
Yeah.
Odysseus returns. Sally, get the cages ready.
Yes, sir, Mr. Market, right away.
Man-eating lion. You didn't think that it might be useful for me to know that this time the animal was actually real, you moron?
Steady on. I clearly stated that we were looking
for... You haven't clearly stated anything in all the time I've known you. That could have been a goose for all I know.
A goose? We'll hardly get them to their feet for the curtain call. Bring on the king of the beasts, on the other hand, and they feel the roar. And they... Well, look about as surprised as you do. What have you done with him, if you don't mind me asking?
I killed him. He's dead.
Bloody hell! This is rum, old boy.
Well, it was him or me. Now, pay me.
Yes, of course, of course. I have just the thing. And what a treasure it is! You're a lucky man, sir. Very lucky man. From the mines of El Dorado. As green as the rainforest, as clear as the Amazon, and as dear as all the gold in the Andes. One man's labor is but a trifle compared to this jewel's true value. Wait! I shouldn't. What would Daddy say?
Your daddy ain't here, and we had a deal.
Yes, of course. A promise is a promise. Sally, get the wagons moving.
Ain't we waiting for the lion?
He's in the great hunting ground in the sky. Good day, sir, and thank you. But we really must be getting along.
Yeah, I won't keep you. So long.
So long, Mr. Morgan. Next time you see me, I'll be topping the bill, I promise. Or at least I'll be on the bill.
All in good time, my dear.
Okay, girl. Yep. Help. Faster. Yeah. Easy.
Hey there, friend. Fire's good and hot.
Howdy.
Mi casa, su casa, friend. So you got a girl, mister? Me neither. Got my eye on one, though. I was hunting north of Annisburg when I came across this cabin. And there's no one there but this woman. Bit bony, but beautiful as the day is long. Real elegant, fancy type, too.
Uh-huh.
I see how you like 'em too, friend. Don't know what she's doing out there in the middle of nowhere, but turns out she's a widow. She asked me to leave, but in a real nice way. Made me feel good. I watched her from the bushes for a while, saw her cry. I think this is a place I could really hang my saddle. A hot dinner and warm bed every night? Don't sound bad to me at all. All right, I need to cool down a bit.
Okay. Oh, shit. Yep. Yeah. Come on! Whoa, whoa!
That's fire. Mind if I warm my bones? Y'all knew these was Murphy Hills. You should be careful where you're camping.
I can look after myself. Besides, it's a free country.
Free country? No. Everything bought and paid for. And we're gonna protect what's ours. Y'all be careful where you wander. Come on, let's go. I think you got the message.
Gonna kill you next time.
Whoa, easy. Yep. Ah. Whoa, come on. wait, girl. Come on, girl. Yep. All right, girl. Mister? Easy, whoa. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Yeah. My girl.
Just calm down.
High time you get yourself off my property.
There we go.
Viste, te lo dije. Sí.
Ah, señor. I think maybe we see if last time was luck,
yeah.
Huh?
Yeah. Yep. Help.
Yeah.
Get up. Now, come on.
Come on in. Take a look, if you will.
Now, let's have a look.
Sure. Sure. Popular even with the tourists here. Not sure if you've met that taxidermist, Mrs. Hobbs, who lives near here. He's quite a character. Keep browsing.
Thank you for your help. Okay, then. Thank you.
Morning.
Thank you.
Okay then, girl. Whoa, easy. 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 There we go. Yeah. Slow it up.
Got nothing better to do?
Look out!
Yeah.
Son of a bitch!
Hey, careful now.
Just a bit, ladies. Go about your business in peace.
There's no sleep over that.
Yeah.
Easy now.
Yep.
So up now.
Now come on.
One that's been causing trouble on what's ours.
All right, easy now. Whoa!
What kind of hellblue got all that blood on you, Arthur?
I'm not sad, just bored.
A stew without good meat is no stew at all, Mr. Morgan.
Good. Bored means you ain't scared. Be grateful for being bored, lady. Soon enough, you're gonna be scared.
Oh, yes. I'll be able to make you something out of this.
I guess I hope for... I don't know. I used to dream a lot.
Good. We really needed this.
When we grew into women... saw what the world was for us. How little it values us. I guess.
Many thanks. Thank you, Arthur.
Try to forget about things.
Hey, if you're struggling for space in your satchel, just bring me the right materials and I'll work something up for you.
Start praying real hard.
Looks great, Pearson.
Ah, Herr Morgan.
Herr Strauss.
How are you enjoying yourself here?
Well enough, I guess. And you?
Well, it turns out the pursuit of freedom is not a cheap business. Not for us, and not for some of the locals.
Sharking already.
I prefer to call it banking.
You ain't the one handing out the beatings.
No, but I am the one feeding the women and children in the camp. What choice do we have, Mr. Morgan?
I don't know. Well, come on then. Tell me who.
Here's the list. Refinery worker turned hunter by the name of Vinton Holmes. You'll find him up in the hills north of Strawberry. Ah, an apprentice undertaker. This one working in Rose. His name was Gwen Hughes.
And how many of them do you think will be able to pay?
With enough encouragement, both of them.
Tabasco.
Easy.
Okay, girl.
Thank God.
Yeah.
Get out of the way.
There.
Good money for your kill. That's one clean kill.
So don't you blame me nothing but your goddamn war.
don't look quite right. Never gonna get the hang of this.
Gwen Hughes, start breaking out a box for yourself if you don't got that money you owe Leopold Strauss.
I need more time.
Doesn't everybody? That casket for you, or you want another?
Wait. I can get it for you. But, come with me to the churchyard. And stay close. Hmm?
All right.
Oh, this ain't right. I'll get you your money, but, well, you'll see.
What ain't right is borrowing money you can't pay back.
I guess you're correct, but, This ain't exactly right, what we're doing.
You ain't the first to put his hand in the collection box, and you won't be the last. Rest a little easier knowing church has been taking more than they need off poor folks since time began.
Well, like I said, well, the morality of the matter is a little more confusing than that.
Okay, you head on in the church, I'll keep watch.
Well, it ain't in there. It's under here. I'm digging up Mrs. Claypole.
Jesus!
Well, she got a bunch of jewels in there that she don't need. Oh, damn it. There's a bunch of people here. Oh, I got it. Look, you clear them off. And I'll wait right around here. But don't hurt nobody. We don't want no fuss.
Don't be shy. Ain't no one around.
Just my auntie.
You two might want to find somewhere a little more private.
We was fine until you got here, mister. Good day now.
Get out of here, kids. Move!
Come on. I knew we shouldn't have been here.
You missed your chance, boy.
Ma'am, would you mind clearing out of here for some maintenance work?
Oh, gladly. It's about time this place got cleaned up.
It's all clear.
All right. Now go watch the gate. I'll get to this, exhumation.
I'm sorry, ma'am. The church grounds are closed for maintenance work.
Well, it's about time, too. The place was in need of some care and attention.
town.
That's for sure.
There's them that's born to it. There's everyone else.
Uh-huh, that's how it is.
Things was done on merit, you and me'd be running things.
Sure would.
Uh-huh.
Hey, look, we're closed for some, excavation work. Would you mind?
No, I ain't gonna mind you at all. You carry on with your business, we'll carry on with ours. This fella. Oh.
Damn choir boy.
Get the hell out of this churchyard. Are you boys gonna need yourselves a preacher?
You hear this fella?
I heard him all right.
We're gonna lick you, bastard. Got some nerve on him. Got.
Shit. I hope this hole dug.
Well, here's your payment. Oh, forgive me, Mrs. Claypole.
What you find?
Well, she had a brooch here. Looks like diamonds.
Well, this'll do. Now get out of here before someone sees you.
Can't believe it's come to this.
Hey, y'all.
Hi, mister.
Good day to you.
Line up, Rhodes. Get your papers.
Of course. Oh.